I'm not going to say I told you so. I'm not going to say I warned you. I'm not going to say that I was the voice calling out in the wilderness, Roseanne is not a conservative, don't trust her, don't follow her, no, don't come back, stop. I won't say that I said any of those things. I said all of those things, okay? I told you. Okay, Roseanne's a crazy person. Roseanne's been a crazy person for years. She ran with Cindy Sheehan on one of these indie party nomination tickets. She took a picture of herself with a Hitler mustache, putting little cookies in the oven that were supposed to be Jews. Okay, Roseanne is a crazy person. She's been a crazy person for a long time. And just because she's a crazy person who happens to like Trump a lot more than some other crazy people, that does not mean that she was ever an ally of conservatives. Well, she demonstrated why it is bad to embrace volatile celebrities who happen to be crazy just yesterday when she decided it would be a great idea to start tweeting about Valerie Jarrett in the most insane possible way. So here is what she tweeted about Valerie Jarrett. Valerie Jarrett, of course, was the kind of unsung chief of staff to Barack Obama. I am not a Valerie Jarrett fan. I think Valerie Jarrett is an awful person. But Valerie Jarrett is also not what Roseanne says she is here. Okay, so Roseanne says Muslim Brotherhood and Planet of the Apes had a baby equals Valerie Jarrett. Okay, so number one. That's disgusting. That's horrifying. You shouldn't be calling black people apes. I mean, I thought there's basically like one rule in the media that you cannot violate if you wish to survive. And Roseanne Barr took that landmine and jumped on it with both feet. And then just in case it didn't go off, she jumped on it again with both feet. So she says she compares Valerie Jarrett to an ape, which is just disgusting and horrifying, especially given the long history in this country of comparing black people to apes, which is just awful and horrifying in every possible way. And then Roseanne's show is dropped. So she tweets this, and then her show dies, right? So ABC pulls her show. It was the number one sitcom on television, so they presumably lost some money on this thing. But it wasn't like ABC didn't know that Roseanne was a crazy person when they hired her. They knew the risks involved when they hired. They bought the ticket. They took the ride. And Roseanne provided them that ride. We'll talk in a second about when it is appropriate for corporations to crack down on so-called free speech. I say so-called because free speech issues are really only implicated when the government is involved. If the government cracks down on your free speech, like Tommy Robinson in the UK, as we discussed yesterday, that's a free speech issue. But when it's a private corporation taking a measure to protect its own products, I'm not quite sure it's the same thing. In fact, I'm sure it's not the same thing. In any case, Roseanne tweets this thing out. Her career is over. She's toast. Goodbye to Roseanne. And frankly, from my perspective, a little bit good riddance. I understand a lot of conservatives were very happy that Roseanne's show did not treat Trump supporters as evil, nasty, terrible people. The problem is that what Roseanne did just allowed the left to treat all Trump supporters as evil, nasty, terrible people. Chris Hayes, for example, over on MSNBC, he tweeted this out, this 15. He tweeted out, quote, Roseanne's problem turned out to be that she far too authentically represented the actual worldview of a significant chunk of the Trump base. Now, he has no basis for saying this. He has no basis for saying that a significant chunk of President Trump's base thinks that black people are apes or that Valerie Jarrett is a mashup of the Muslim Brotherhood and Planet of the Apes. He has no data to support this. But it doesn't matter. Roseanne just provided a crowbar for the left to whack people with, which is really just a wonderful thing to do. And the left jumped on it with alacrity. So Valerie Jarrett, of course, responded, and she responded by ripping into President Trump and talking about everyday racism in America. I do have to point out that this clip from MSNBC is extraordinary for a couple of reasons. One, I just want you to look at this panel. Okay, look at this panel. So you got Chris Hayes, right, who's the guy sitting right there who just said that Trump's base supports this kind of stuff. And then next to him, you have Joy Reid. Okay, Joy Reid is a person who just a couple of weeks ago nearly lost her job because it turns out that she'd written a bunch of posts that were deemed homophobic and offensive and anti-Semitic and all this stuff. And she claimed that she didn't write them. And then she claimed that she had amnesia. And she claimed that she was hacked. Okay, and Joy Reid is still sitting on the set now talking about the stuff that Roseanne tweeted. So just to be straight here, Roseanne tweets something, loses her job. Joy Reid tweets stuff that's really gross, not only maintains her job, but gets to sit on set with Valerie Jarrett discussing the evils of Twitter racism. So there's that. And then sitting next to Valerie Jarrett on the other side is Al Sharpton. Al Sharpton, the leading race baiter of the last 40 years in the United States, a man who suggested that Jews in New York City were white interlopers, a guy who suggested that they were diamond merchants, a guy who nearly initiated a riot, maybe initiated a riot in Crown Heights in 1991 that ended in the death of an Orthodox Jew. He said about Orthodox Jews, there's an Orthodox Jew who accidentally hit a black kid with his car. And Al Sharpton said, if they want to fight, why don't they pin on their yarmulkes and come on over to my house? Al Sharpton, that piece of dreck, okay, he's a bad guy, Al Sharpton. That guy is sitting there talking about the evils of Roseanne. So I do have to point out the media's double standard here. Roseanne should have lost her job for reasons that I will explain in just a second. First of all, It really should require no explanation. That statement for a public figure, you lose your job. End of story. But the media, to refrain from pointing out the double standard when Joy Reid, who tweeted out a bunch of other gross stuff, and Al Sharpton, who is one of the worst race baiters in the history of the United States, at least in modern American history, to have those two people commenting on it with Valerie Jarrett, who was targeted by Roseanne, but also happened to be a member of an administration that was very happy to polarize along the basis of race, it provides a little bit of irony sitting there alongside Chris Hayes, who says that all Trump supporters are basically Roseanne. Ay, ay, ay. Anyway, here's Valerie Jarrett commenting on the situation.
Well, first of all, I think we have to turn it into a teaching moment. I'm fine. I'm worried about all the people out there who don't have a circle of friends and followers who come right to their defense. The person who's walking down the street minding their own business and they see somebody cling to their purse or want to cross the street. Or every black parent I know who has a boy who has to sit down and have a conversation, the talk, as we call it. And those, as you say, those ordinary examples of racism that happen every single day.
Okay, so now we get this routine where everybody is Roseanne, where America is replete with Roseannes, where people in their back room are tweeting out crazy stuff like Roseanne. Roseanne is a crazy person. Roseanne tweeted out that she was on Ambien, and that's why she tweeted this out, which prompted Ambien in pretty hilarious fashion to tweet back, "One of our side effects does not include racism." So good for Ambien. And it's true. Whenever I saw those Ambien commercials, I never saw that butterfly with the KKK hood on it. That was just, I never picked up on that. But Valerie Jarrett suggesting that we are all Roseanne is the stupidest thing in the world. Roseanne did something bad. And you know what the effect was? She lost her job. She lost a multi-million dollar job as the top sitcom performer in the United States. And Valerie Jarrett is saying this somehow impugns the entire United States. Somehow this is everyday racism in America. Hey, it's not everyday racism in America, because if it were everyday racism in America, Roseanne wouldn't have lost her job. I'm kind of getting sick of this routine where we smear the entire American public and all Trump supporters with the brush of Roseanne Barr. Okay, then Joy Reid comments on Roseanne. Okay, so here's Joy Reid, again, a woman who tweeted out a bunch of really nasty stuff like 4 weeks ago and then recalled that she had amnesia. She literally claimed she had amnesia, which is a plot line that went out of soap operas in the 1980s. She claimed that she had amnesia. She still has a job and she gets to comment on Roseanne Barr. Here is Joy Reid on MSNBC commenting on it.
They see this as no big deal, that this is something that you should be able to say. Why can't you say it? It's just jokes. Why are people taking it to heart? That's part of the problem, is that you have a certain set of people who feel that you should be able to speak this way. And unfortunately, you know, we have a president at the moment who's kind of giving a broad sense of permission to not be politically correct, to speak the way you want, to offend who you want, and that people really shouldn't have a right to say anything about it.
Okay, this is all straw man. I didn't see one major conservative commentator yesterday saying Roseanne should have kept her job. Not one. Okay, the number of conservative commentators who said Roseanne should have kept her job, it was relegated to like Jack Posobiec and maybe like Ali, like a couple of guys who are really fringe and aren't considered mainstream right figures in any case. But they're treating it as though the entire right came out swarming in defense of Roseanne Barr. Obviously not true. Obviously not real. But the entire left did come out swarming for Joy Reid, right? So if you're gonna tar one movement with the actions of a bad person, you might want to tar the movement with the person they actually defend. So if you want to say that Trump's base is willing to defend his excesses, that I agree with. But if you want to say that Trump's base is willing to defend Roseanne Barr, I don't see Trump's base defending Roseanne Barr today. And the same thing is not true of Joy Reid. The entire left base came out in defense of Joy Reid. Very few of them wanted Joy Reid to lose her job. The same thing is true of Louis Farrakhan, of Linda Sarsour, of a bunch of people, Keith Ellison, who have associated with the worst kinds, Al Sharpton, you know, terrible, terrible people who have been defended repeatedly by the left. Roseanne Barr lost her job after less than like 4 hours after this tweet came out. So don't tell me the entire right-wing base is supporting Roseanne Barr. It just ain't true. And Trump isn't even supporting Roseanne Barr. So Al Sharpton, again, the idea the media is going to try Al Sharpton as some sort of great race relations expert is just beyond, it's beyond sickening. Here is Al Sharpton lauding the Roseanne cancellation.
Roseanne has the right to be a supporter of whatever politics she wants. But to take this kind of obvious racial rhetoric to compare a learned, respected public service like Valerie Jarrett to a ape reminds us of all of the history of blacks being called monkeys. And I think that Disney and ABC did the right thing. And I think they've opened the door now to see other things that they're doing.
Okay, so there you are, Al Sharpton, leading race baiter of our time, commenting on Roseanne, also apparently a race baiter. And one of them still has a job. So it does show you the double standard in the media. In just a second, I want to talk about Van Jones, too, was sounding off on the Roseanne situation. And he is blaming President Trump for it, obviously, because President Trump, it's amazing. Everybody seems to think that the universe revolves around President Trump. So Roseanne does something bad, and suddenly it has to do with President Trump. I'm not sure what Roseanne has to do with Trump, other than Roseanne was a Trump supporter. But Harvey Weinstein was a Hillary Clinton supporter, and I'm not sure why. If Hillary were president right now, I do not think you'd see a lot of headlines about Hillary supporter Harvey Weinstein goes on and is tried for rape. I just don't think that would be the headline. Now, to be a little bit fairer, Roseanne was portraying a Trump supporter on TV, but this was always the danger of her portraying a Trump supporter on TV. I mentioned it at the time. I did nearly a full show on it. I talked about how Trump's portrayal of Trump supporters was not helpful to Trump supporters, and that when you tether your boat to crazy people, bad things happen. As I said about Kanye West, listen, I'm happy Kanye wants to do the open your mind thing, but live by the Kanye, die by the Kanye. Live by the Roseanne, die by the Roseanne. Okay, but in any case, here's Van Jones trying to tie Trump to Roseanne as though Trump was somehow using Roseanne as his meat puppet, like he had his hand in the back of her head and was actually manipulating her mouth to call Valerie Jarrett an ape.
It could be that this moral collapse inside of our political system, and especially inside the White House, is being counterbalanced now by people in mainstream media, mainstream corporations, to say, listen, we don't want to live in a country where, good and decent people can be attacked for no reason with despicable terms. And it's very important to know it's not a joke. It's not funny.
OK, so I agree it's not a joke, and I agree it's not funny. To pretend that Donald Trump is the person who has laid our rhetoric low in American public life is to ignore a lot of American public rhetoric in the last 15 years. I mean, it was Joe Biden who in 2012 was going around saying that Mitt Romney legitimately wanted to put y'all back in chains. It was the Democratic Party who within the last 10 years was producing videos of Paul Ryan throwing old women off the edge of cliffs with their wheelchairs. So before we go to the Donald Trump destroyed American rhetoric, a sentiment with which I have some agreement, you do have to actually provide the context for that destruction of American rhetoric. And nobody, including Trump, was saying that this kind of stuff was okay, right? Trump was not saying that any of this stuff was okay. Roseanne Barr, by the way, went back on Twitter later in the evening and started tweeting out more random crazy stuff. Again, she blamed Ambien. And then she claimed that she didn't know that Valerie Jarrett was black. She said she thought that Valerie Jarrett was white and Jewish, which makes no sense since she accused her of being a member of the Muslim Brotherhood. All of which demonstrates that maybe Roseanne Barr is crazy, as I said, repeatedly, over and over. But now, listen, because I'm right. Okay, so the reason I say that you should listen is because I'm going to tell you about another celebrity situation inside the Republican Party.